So thank you to be here. My name is Philippe Charrière. I am tech evangelist and sales manager too, but I continue to code at Clever Cloud. We provide PaaS solution for developers. But the most important thing today, I am core committer for the Eclipse Gololang project. So if you are here to hear something about Go language, it's not the same thing, okay? It's a Golo language. So, who is a Java programmer in here? Okay, so it's not so important. So what is Golo? Golo, it's a dynamic language, so there is no type for the DVM, built from the beginning with Invoke Dynamic. At the start, it was a scientist or research project created by Julien Ponge from the French CityLab team. And now it's an Eclipse project. Golo is almost famous. The Jack Center website has done a nice infographic about Java ecosystem. And we are at the bottom of the infographic. There is a little island with the Golo name. On the same website, you can read a very nice and instructive interview of Yannick Loiseau, the co-leader of the Golo project, and it's a good little introduction to the Golo language. But about this presentation, why such a title, the tiny language that gives superpowers? In fact, I'm not a real Java developer and not a Java ninja. But thanks to Golo, I learned to read the Java doc. I progressed a lot in Java. Most important, I participate to an open source project, and working with very clever people is very instructive. And I do things I didn't do before. For example, I can change a programming language. I can add some features to Golo. Or even I can speak English in public, and probably it's the most difficult part. So you can hear I have a kind of exotic English. And don't panic, sometimes perhaps it will be some blanks during the presentation because I forgot the word. So you can help me if you find the word. We have not enough time to talk about all Golo language, so I choose to present to my mind the most representative things about this language. And you can see this talk as an introduction course of the language. We are talking about the simplicity of Golo. So how can you do your first Hello World program and compile it and run it? I will talk about Golo specificities like dynamic object, structures, loop, etc. I will speak about some functional programming with optional end result. This is helpers to do some functional programming very easily. Another thing, Golo, there is a love story between Golo and Java. So I show you how we can augment Java classes and use other frameworks like Vertex, RPI4G or Fimata4G to do some kind of IoT with Raspberry Pi or Arduino. And the last part of the talk is a little demo. I explain how you can add features and keywords to Golo to create kind of DSL for children, for example, and I will display some moving emojis in the terminal. I use Golo in the real life to do some code generators, quick web application, and learning frameworks, and do some proof of concept. So, a quick landscape of Golo. Golo is very easy to install. You just have to download it, unzip it, and change your environment variable. It runs, of course, on OS 6, Linux, and Windows. Perhaps you have to do some changed for Windows about the environment variable, but all is explained in the documentation. You can too fork or clone the project and build it with a Gradle script. It's very easy, and after you have to change your environment variable. It's useful, especially if you want to become a committer on the Golo project. And you can try, it's very easy. So, my first Hello World program. Golo code is simple. You have to define a module name with a keyword module and name the module. You have to write a main function, like in Java. The notation is, like my English, a little bit exotic. There is no parenthesis for function, but pipes. I don't know why. And we have a semicolon at the end of the line. And that's it. To run a Golo code, there are several ways. You can compile with the command Golo compile your Golo code, and then you can run the bytecode with Golo run command. You can do to some Maven or Gradle project with option Maven, then you can package some jar application, like any other Java application, and then execute it. With the same command, but with different option with profile, you can create library and use it with after with other Golo program or even Java program. And there is a third way, my favorite way. You can execute Golo code as a script with a Golo command, and you define the jar you need with ClassPass option, the file you need with the files option, and you have the main file at the end of the line, like this. ClassPass is very interesting because you can use other program like Vertex, for example, to create easily some web application. There is module and function with Golo. So we have seen the module keyword. And then you can add a function like that. And there is a short version too, a short notation with an arrow notation. And you don't need the return keyword in this case. And then with another file, you can import your module and use your function just in calling them. By the way, the variable and are declared with the var keyword and the constant reference like that with let keyword. Unless you need mutability, I advise you to use let. It's better than var, to my mind. Since the beginning, Golo supports lambdas, even before Java 8, because the first version of Golo was built with Java 7. So lambda is defined like a function, but you affect it to a reference or a variable like that. And then you can use it. You can use a compact version of notation too, and then you can use it in your program like this. So it's very easy. You can call function or lambda that return function or lambda, like in JavaScript, for example. Who is JavaScript programmer? Nice, I love JavaScript. For example, like that. I do a lambda something that return another lambda, that return a sum and a division. And then I can write it like that. It's shorter. Perhaps not less readable, but shorter. And you can use like that. You call first something, and then you pass the parameters to the result. Or you can prepare some operation at the beginning of the program, like divide sum, and reuse it several times in your program, like inside the println. As all other programming languages, we have some control on the loop construction. For example, of course, we have the classical if-else. You don't need the then. You just add two brackets. Curly bracket, sorry. We have case construction too with when and otherwise keyword. There is another construction like match, a kind of pattern matching. I have not a slide about match, but we'll see an example later in the presentation. We have loop structures too, like the classical while. So just while with a condition, parentheses, you can write it without the parentheses. We have for each loop like this, and we have something very useful to avoid the condition if item like that. You can add some guards with a when keyword at the end of the loop. So it's more readable. Before going further, I want to show you that it's very easy for Golo to use Java types. For example, here I use a pure Java linked list. You can see we don't need to use the new keyword to get an instance of the class. You have just to call the name of the class. And then you can add item like in Java to the new linked list. Pay attention to the colon notation. To call an instance method with Golo, you need the colon notation. By the way, the space after the colon is totally optional. So, I think it's nicer, but you don't need it. Then you can call static or class method, like the join method of string with a dot notation. So you can make the difference between the instance notation and class notation. And you can simplify, with, thanks to Golo, more this kind of code like this. Golo had some sugars to the collection, like in JavaScript. And there is directly a list, and you can add item directly at the creation of the list. And we don't need, for example, like in Java 8, sorry, the stream method. We can use directly map or reduce method, but the augmentation of the collection with Golo are non-lazy. Each time you use map, you get directly a new collection. Golo supports all the common Java collection like array, list, vector, set, and map, and we have two, tuple and range. All this is completely documented on the website. So we have seen the essential things to write some Golo code. Now it's time to talk about some specificities. There is something very strange or weird at the beginning when you try to make your first program. There is no class with Golo language. So first time, no class and no inheritance. Like JavaScript again before ES6, for example. But we have something else, the thing that I love so much with Golo, the dynamic object. This is like in C#, for example, you can add a value or method dynamically at the runtime to an object, like that. So here I create a dynamic object, I name it Clark. I add two properties or field, first name and last name. I can set it at the since the beginning. And after, I can add some method with a defined keyword. And I pass a lambda as a parameter to create the method. You see that you need this as the first parameter. This is a reference at the dynamic object. This is only a notation. You can name it with self or that or what you want. But in the team, generally use this. And then you can use your object in calling method or properties. Properties are like getter and setter. And you can add a new method if you want inside the source code. There is something very useful with dynamic object. Each dynamic object has a mixin method. So I create a powers dynamic object with a fly method, and then I can transplant it to the two other dynamic objects, Clark and Kara, so they inherit like traits from the fly method. Then you can share method with mixin. There are other superpowers for dynamic objects, but once again, it's in the documentation. This is very dynamic, so if you need a program that runs very quick, this is not the best object or features of Golo to use. We have something less dynamic but powerful. We have structures like in the Go language. It's easy to use and to create. We have a struct keyword. And after, inside the struct, you define the field like here with first name and last name. Then you can create an instance of your structure just calling it by his name. And you can set the field inside the constructor or after inside the getter and the setter. You have automatically getter and setter with a structure. And the next feature is that you can augment structures. You can add some method to a structure like that. You define your structure, and then you can augment it and add to it some method. And you can see that you can override a method, for example, like that. And then you can just use call the method like any other object, dynamic object, or Java class. There is named augmentation. You can create an augmentation that you can share with several structures, like traits, like the mixin method of the dynamic object before. So here I create a hit method and I transplant it to human and dog, and I can use it after in my code. There is something important, we'll see it after, but I can do the same thing with existing Java class. So you can add some method to another framework, for example. With Golo, you can do some asynchronous programming. There is a lot of helper to do that, but we have promise, like in JavaScript. For example, here it's a very dirty translation of a Java sample I found to do HTTP request. So it's a synchronous call. So if I get content of the Google homepage, I need to wait for the end of the to get the content before to do a new get content. So all is synchronous, and sometimes you need to have a non-blocking program. So there is a promise keyword. And you can, with it, encapsulate your synchronous code to do it with in a synchronous way. So here, I create a new lambda, or you can create a function with the new with promise keyword. I initialize my code inside a thread. It's a keyword because I can do promise without thread two, but it's less interesting. I need two parameters, two lambdas for the resolve and reject method. And then I run my code inside the try catch. So I get my content. If all is okay, I pass the content to the resolve lambda. And if I have an error, I pass the error to the reject lambda. The use code is more readable. In fact, I call my new function with the URL google.com. It returns to me a promise with two methods, onSet and onFail, and I put the code inside each method. And onSet is the resolve parameter, and onFail is the reject parameter. There are some other helpers to do some asynchronous code, like workers. I have no slide about workers, but workers with Golo are like workers in JavaScript. So, somebody does Scala language or Haskell? Yes? With Golo, you can do functional programming, for example, a recurrent error in programming is a null pointer exception, and Golo offers utilities to deal with this problem, like the optional Java or the maybe Haskell. And with Golo, we call it option, but in fact, it's simply an augmentation of the optional Java types. Excuse me. Here, I have a list of some structures, body with an ID and an avatar. I can find in the list a body by his ID, but if I call the avatar getter of null bodies or non-existent body, I get a Java null pointer exception. So now I can modify my search by returning an option of my search. And then if the body exists, I will get an optional type of my body. Or if the body doesn't exist, I get an optional with nothing inside. And then I can test it. I can test if I have something or if I have nothing. So you are obliged to test your code, and then there is no more null pointer exception. If you want to get the value inside the optional, you have the or else method, and then you can get the result, the structure, if it exists, and if it doesn't exist, you get a default body, for example, like the body with zero ID and the robot face avatar. It's okay for the moment? Okay. There is a method very interesting on optional. It is the either method. So each time you get an optional, empty or not, you have the either method, and you can pass two lambda to it, one to get the value body, and then if it's okay, you can do something or return another thing. And the second parameters, if it's null, you can declanche another treatment, for example, or return something. So the first is executed when you get a value, and the second when the value is null. But sometimes there is other errors than null pointer exception, and it's the option is not enough convenient to deal with it. So we have two other helpers, the result and error, but the use of them is similar. Here, I made divide lambda or divide function. I do a try catch. If all is okay, I return a result with the result of my division. And if I have an error, like division by zero, for example, I return an error. So it's easy to test, and you can qualify the error because you can pass it to the error constructor. You have something shorter with the keyword trying. You don't need to write the try catch. So it's more readable. We have also a kind of decorator of function to do something, but it's another story. And like for the optional, we have the either method too. Then you can get the result or you can get the error inside. I have a sample next with Vertex, and you will see that it's easy to deal with error, especially with HTTP error, for example. There are some other functional features like union type, but I can do almost an entire talk about this feature, so read the documentation. So, I said at the beginning that Golo loves very well Java, and it's very easy to use Java classes with Golo. For example, on the left side, I have a Java class, the Toon class, and on the right side, I have the Golo code to use this class. So you can see, I just have to call the Toon name with the name inside the constructor, and after, I can use the getter or the setter of the Java class directly with the colon notation. You can see that there is no more get or set before name. You can call directly the name of the field. You don't need to prefix with get and set. If you do that, it's okay too, but I think it's nicer to do that like this. And you can call the static method getInstance with a dot, and use the method of the class, use hug method, with the colon notation. But there is something very, very interesting. I can use augment with the Java class. So here, for example, I add a method to my Java class, and then I can use it after in my code source. So it's very useful if you want to create some DSL or helpers for other Java frameworks, or to simplify the use of Java frameworks. So it's the next part of the presentation. So Golo and the other frameworks, I'll told you that there is no class and inheritance with Golo. So sometimes it's not very convenient when you want to use some frameworks, but we have Golo adapters. An adapter with Golo allows you to do the definition of an object at runtime that can extend a Java type. Who knows RxJava? Okay. So RxJava deals about observer and observable. Here, it's a Java code. I have an observable that generates some data each 1 second. And I need an observer to observe this observable. So I have to create a new observer. I name it observer. And I have to implement four methods: unsubscribe, unnext, unerror, and uncomplete. And then I run my code during 5 seconds. And it display five smileys with each second. It's not very complicated. With Golo, to use RxJava, the code is almost the same. I can use directly the observable and interval method of the observable to get a new observable to define a source. But for the observer, I need to create an adapter of the interface reactivex.observer. And after, I can implement each method. And then, I can create an observer with an instance of my adapter. and I can use it like the Java code in the slide before. This is a specificity of the Golo language, but with experience, it's easy to use, and you can simplify a lot the Java source code. In fact. So I can't remember if I ask who knows or knows and use Vertex. Just one. So at 10:20 in the same room, there will be Clément Escoffier. He's in the Vertex team, and he can speak about this, and it's very interesting. Vertex can help you to create, for example, very quickly in Java or in JavaScript, or with Groovy, or with Scala, some web application, like, they are very similar, to my mind, to the ExpressJS framework, but you can do a lot of things more because the Java ecosystem is larger. You can do IoT, you can create easily MQTT broker, for example. So I engage you to listen, Clément, at 10:20. So, this is a Java web application with Vertex. This is Java code. So, I create a router. I define two routes, about and hello. I can send JSON content to my browser with the AND method of the response object. I can get some JSON string, from the body with the getBody as JSON method of the request object. And then I have just to use the listen method of the server to start my my web application. Even if Java is very verbose, I found it very readable, but few augmentation letters with Golo, and I can do something like that. So create HTTP server and get router are just some function to encapsulate some call of the Vertex framework. I have do augmentation of the router to have something shorter to create my route. I add a djson method to response to generate, in fact, a dynamic object. So each field of the dynamic object becomes a field, a JSON field, and then I just have to send it. I add a dbody method to the routing context, and then I can parse easily the body of the field of the body. In fact, it's a JSON casting of object, and I have just to start my server. This is the augmentation. It's not very complicated, and in fact, I add only add some shortcuts to the Vertex classes method. I give an URL of a repository on GitHub with all the code, and you can run it easily. There is a functional way to do a Vertex web app with Golo, with using trying. Then in this case, trying return an object or an error, and it's very easy to deal with HTTP error, for example, and to catch the code. It's like some Scala code with pattern matching when you test the option or the result object. I will publish the slideware, but the code with Vertex web application is here. I plan to add more features in the future. I do some IoT with Golo. Who knows what is IoT? Okay. So yes, Internet of Things. I have a hobby. I love playing with Raspberry Pi and Arduino, but I'm not very talented because I only flash LED. After, it's more complicated, and I stop, and I have two more cable, and it's too difficult. But it's a good proof that Golo can deal with embedded software on a very little computer. I make a video of a demonstration I've done. Yes. Here, it's a Raspberry Pi Zero. Inside the Raspberry, I have Vertex, I have Golo, so I have a JVM too. I use the P4G Java library. The P4G Java library helped me to communicate with the GPIO of the Raspberry to blink the LED. The GPIO is the pin to plug the cable on the breadboard and to plug it to the LED. And with Vertex, I communicate with the board and with my my browser. And each time I click on a button, I blink the green, red, or blue LED. It's not very difficult. The main code is here. I define a LED structure with a pin, port identification number. With a reference to a board, and I have to call the digital output pin method of the P4G library. After, I have defined some augmentation for each component, for each LED, so the blink method. But if I call it, it will be executed in a synchronous way. So I add and so if I count blink, green, red, and blue at the same time. So I create a new method, I call it worker, that spawn a new worker to create a task in background. So I can blink all the LED at the same time with that. It was the workers of the beginning of the presentation. So the web app looked like that. I create some LED. I create a worker thanks to my LED with the worker method. And inside this worker, I call the blink method. Then I have a route, blink slash the color of the LED. And each time I click on a button, it's called this route, and then I check if it is red, green, or blue with the match keyword. I talked about this at the beginning, and it's almost like pattern matching, but not quite the same thing, but very, very useful. And then it spawned my worker in an asynchronous way. So it's very easy to do that. I know that some people prefer Arduino than Raspberry Pi. Me, I don't like C language because I don't know why, but I don't like it. And I don't do Arduino, but there is a Java library, is named Firmata 4G, and that fits very well with Golo. Who know Firmata? So, never mind. Firmata, it's a protocol and a program. So, in fact, you flash the Arduino memory with Firmata, and there is a program that listens for commands. And after, with the Firmata library, it exists for different languages. On a Raspberry Pi or on your laptop, you can send command to the Arduino directly to tell him, please blink the LED, for example. In JavaScript, there is a framework named Johnny5, which is very, very easy to use. And that works for Arduino, but for a lot of other microcontrollers. So the use of Fermata 4G is very easy. You just have to create a device on a communication port, get an instance of a component. You have to name it and to pass the pin number of the component. After, you just have to call the blink method of the library. So it's very easy to use if you prefer Arduino than Raspberry. So to my mind, Golo is a language very easy to learn and try IoT. You can have the benefit of all the Java ecosystem, and you can experiment easily. For example, I am not obliged to compile my code each time on the Raspberry Pi, and I can access to the code in SSH and just update the code and re-execute it. So to experiment before compile it, for example, it's easier. I have started some experiment with MQTT and Vertix. You can find it here to create some MQTT gateways on Raspberry Pi. So if you want to play with MQTT, I have started a kind of broker, a very, very simple broker, and I use Pao library as a client, and it's very, very easy to use. And you can ask me on the repository or by Twitter if you want something. But to my mind, the most interesting features of Golo is that it is the real power of Golo. You can add your own features or your own keyword to the language. Then you can become a Golo committer, if the feature is interesting, of course. There is several ways to modify Golo. I will show you after. As I said, I'm not a real Java developer. I prefer JavaScript and Node.js. Node.js because I'm not good in the front development. It's okay, but it's very bad, not nice. But I made some accepted pull requests on the Golo project, and it's very easy to add features. There is three ways. You can add features in Java. It's easy. You can add features in Golo. It's easier, and you can do invoke dynamic too. But I have not the level to explain you how to do that because. I can understand invoke dynamic. You need to be a Java ninja. So to do that, you have to, of course, fork the Golo project or clone if you just want to experiment on your laptop, but no publish your pull request. And this is the Golo project. You can read the screen. There is two important directories in the Golo project. There is a Java directory, and you can find some Java class. There is a predefined Java class, which is very important. Each time you add a static method in this class, in fact, you add a keyword in Golo. This was my first pull request some years ago. I met Julien, the creator of Golo, and I told him that I don't understand. There is no readLN method. What have you done? And he answered me. You can do it yourself. So I was so surprised. But some hours ago, I decided to open the project and read the code. And in fact, it's very easy to add. A readLN method, you can see at the near the arrow, it's just one line for the readLN method. But I wasn't a Java programmer. And after, you have another directory, the Golo directory, and you can add some Golo features, some Golo code in pure Golo inside this directory, and you can add augmentation to Java classes in Golo this in this repository, and you can add very interesting features. This is my last pull request. I have add something to cast trees of dynamic object to JSON and JSON to tree of dynamic object. So except the invoke dynamic part, it's very easy to do, and I hope. And this is my demonstration, a quick demonstration. Imagine that I want to create a Golo for kid version. I try to explain to my son and my daughter how to code, but they are not real geeks for the moment. They are 12 and 11, but... So, demo time. Okay, we don't need the... So, I create a new branch. It's cleaner. We put Golo for kid. Up. This is my Golo project. I have no memory. I am like a goldfish, so I will do some copy paste source code. Okay. So here I have a very simple Java class in a Gololang Acme package. So I copy the code. I go in the Gololang package of the project. I add a new Java class. I save it. So I have just a class with an avatar and a coordinate and a constructor. I want to add method to this class to move, for example, each avatar in a terminal. I can add it in the class, but I will augment my class with Golo code. So I go in the Golo directory. So I name my module with the same name of package than the Toon class. And I augment my Java class with a display function. So cursor, position, print, and some other word, Golo features. I add a display mission. Method, erase method, right to go right, left to go right, done and up. So it's very, very simple. Then it's almost finished. Shift. Oh. Ah. To recompile Golo, I just need to call the install dist Gradle build straight. So if all is all right, I built it. My laptop is not very powerful, so it can take a little time. No, it's okay. So now I have some code of demo code to use my new features. Like this, I import my new package and I will display a rabbit in the terminal. So Open terminal here. So to run the code as a script, because I don't want to compile it, I type golo golo -files demo1.golo. And you see, it's very complicated. I have a rabbit on my screen. My son like that. And the other, a little bit more complicated, but just a little bit, is this. In fact, I create 5 tunes, and 10 times I move it on the screen, each 1 second. Up. I think, I'm not sure you can do that with Windows because some Unicode I haven't tested, but you see you can do some things very simple for kids, for example. In fact, the aim of Golo is that you can almost create your own language and add some features to your own aim. And it's very, very easy to do. So I have finished, not totally finished. Wait a minute. So thank you. Thank you to Coderot. To, before the question, one more thing. I don't know if you know the Tech.io platform. It is a platform to create some course for any language, like JavaScript, Java, etc. And I have started just started for the moment. I have 1 or 2 screens. I have started a Golo code, so you can test it without install it, and there will be some question, quiz, etc. Then this is the end. It's time of questions. Not too hard, please. Nothing about Invoke Dynamic, for example. I can't. If you have no question, or you can ping me outside and ask me what you want about Golo language.